मेरा रेसलिंग करियर में सबसे बिगेस्ट मोमेंट अंडर 23 और चैम्पियनशिप था, और वो भी सिल्वर मेडल आया वहाँ पे। मेरी बहुत ही क्लोज बाउट थी 4-4 के स्कोर से, लड़कियाँ पार्टिसिपेट कर रही थी, सिर्फ मेरा ही मेडल आया था, तो उस चीज की वो खुशी भी थी, और कहीं ना कहीं वो था कि मैं गोल्ड जीत सकती थी। उन्हें मार्शल आर्ट में रेसलिंग काफ़ी सपोर्ट कर रही है। जब मैं ट्रेनिंग में गई पहली बार, तो मेरी मोई थाई की ट्रेनिंग थी, तो मेरे जब देखा तो मुझे थोड़ा अजीब सा लग रहा था कि मैं कर पाऊँगी नहीं कर पाऊँगी, लेकिन जब मुझे यहाँ पे कोच के कॉम्प्लीमेंट मिले कि बहुत अच्छा कर रही है, तो उससे मेरी कॉन्फिडेंस भी आ गया। और तो मुझे अपनी बहनों से मिला है, क्योंकि उन्होंने एक अलग रेसलिंग को एक अलग मुकाम पे लिया है, तो मैं भी चाहती हूँ कि मैं भी एक कुछ अलग हटके करूँ। ये एक चीज़ है कि मुझे कुछ अलग करना है, कुछ हिस्ट्री बनानी है, तो वही चीज़ मुझे एक रोज़
get that pin on the board. Let's see how the yoga and the meditation over the last 4 weeks pays off for Rajinder Singh Meena.
Typically we see Rajinder Singh Meena only moving back and forth. I'd like to see him utilize some lateral movement, moving left and moving right, always moving his head.
Two very large, well-built lightweights, and oh, Rajinder Singh Meena gets it knocked down. The ground and pound, he'll try and sink a choke. A house on fire, the Indian. Find the finish here. This would be a huge upset. Zhang Zhihao stuck in his attempted guillotine at the moment. He's finally done it. Rajinder Singh Meena has rendered Zhang Zhihao momentarily out of it to take the victory in the sweetest of fashions. My word, Mitch. Certainly the yoga and meditation paid off.
That's all he needed was to get his mind right. He has all the skills to reach the very top, and he did it tonight. What a tremendous punch landed. As Zhang Jia was coming in, he caught him. Decided not to go for the ground and pound. Saw the guillotine open, jumped on the choke.
We have never seen Rajinder Singh Meena with this sort of self-confidence, and it paid huge dividends.
Tremendous, look at that, caught him with a big right hand. Didn't choose the ground and pound, chose to adjust the guillotine. Look at him, consistently moving, there it is. Bingo, right on the button. Ket Jong coming in, puts him down, jumps all over him. Big submission win for Rajinder Singh Meena.
That is huge for Rajinder, that is huge for India and Indian martial arts. Let's go to Dominic Lau to make it all official.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Kim Chang, has put a stop to this contest after 42 seconds in the first round for your winner by way of guillotine, Rajinder Singh Meena.
He still can't believe it. And I'm sure many people watching around the world can't either. Zhang Zhihao, his first ever loss. Rajinder Singh Meena, in epic fashion, gets his first ever one championship win, first round guillotine. You could not have predicted that. In front of us, our crowd inside Istana Senayan in Jakarta, Indonesia. And Wimbango continue her winning way. She's in southpaw stance here in the pink, black and grey. Pooja Tolma of India in the white trunks. Jab two, high right roundhouse, put nothing but air there for Tolma. Good two punch combination from the Indian. Marcella Hertati Limbungo, her name is long, it reads like an eye chart, but her facts can be very short. She can finish them quickly.
Watch Priscilla try to lure Poja Tomar into a false sense of security by striking with her. And she's gonna slide in for that double leg, and the attack that single leg because it's right there.
Both women know each other extremely well. Pooja Toma said she studied hours of video on Priscilla Hurtati Limbongo and found some chinks in the armor of the Indonesian. And she exposed Priscilla tonight. If Priscilla gets the win, particularly by knockout or submission, they will have an absolute meltdown inside this sold-out arena. Good release of the right hand there from Priscilla.
Look at Priscilla, very happy to engage. Very comfortable stance in that southpaw position. She utilized that push kick very well. Nice little counter there from Tomar.
Omar had the right idea. She's switching between orthodox and southpaw too. A little bit of a Wushu sidekick there was Priscilla Hurtati Limbongo. If you've seen Wushu competition before, you know that the cutting sidekick to the midsection or to the top of the thigh is one of the prime weapons in the Wushu arsenal. A right roundhouse kick there from Toma. As I said, in every match tonight, we feature champions from all different martial arts. Here we have two Wushu champions in the cage. And Toma trying to look both her hands.
Toma is touching up the face of Priscilla Hurtati Limbongo. You can see the damage starting to build up. Priscilla's marching forward now, keeping staying nice and light on her feet. Tomar's a little bit more flat-footed.
A 15-5 record in Wushu for Priscilla Hurtati Limbongo. Tomar, a four-time national Wushu champion between 2014 and 2017, competing at 48 kilograms. There's that sidekick again from Priscilla Hurtati Limbongo. A little flat-footed here, Priscilla. More on the balls of her feet is Pooja Tomar. There's a sidekick from the Indian. Switches to orthodox stance. That's her preferred stance.
It's interesting how they're changing it up because I just said the exact opposite of what you just said. But Tomar, she is mixing things up though. She is changing between the stance and that seems to be effective for her. She said that was her game plan coming in, was to try to confuse Priscilla Hurtati Limbongo to not give her the same look, and she's doing that. She's also piecing up a little bit.
Priscilla's got to watch the left hand of Tomar. Already there is quite a bit of swelling above the right eye of Priscilla Hurtati Limbongo. Take down there, and Tomar finds herself in top position. Looking to pass the guard of the Indonesian.
Look at Tomar getting the takedown there off that headlock throw. Changing the game a little bit on Priscilla Hurtati Limbongo. Now she's in the top position. Priscilla's just holding on to the head there, hoping for possibly a stand-up. Maybe want to get those butterfly hooks in and elevate the hips because you can see how forward Tomar is. She's really coming in forward, a little bit of balance. She's got to sit back into her hips and stay nice and balanced.
Pooja Tomar has never won by submission. Priscilla has 2 out of 5 wins by submission. Ground and pound attempt, looks to pass to side control now Tomar, and gets there the Indian. Have a look at this from Pooja Tomar. She's going to try and mount Priscilla Hurtati Limbongo. She takes the back. It's crazy here from Tomar. She's got her back. Oh, my. She got the hooks in. And can she flatten her out? Yes, she can.
Wow, that's a shocker. Look at Tomar getting control of the back now to end the round. She's got about 18 seconds here. Let's see if she can stick in that rear naked choke. She might just want to throw some bombs now.
Pooja Tomar flops her out like an Indonesian pancake. My word, Pooja Tomar in control. Nobody expected this. Nobody expected this. Incredible save here in Jakarta.
Wow, Pooja Tomar came here to spoil the Indonesian party. Getting the back of Priscilla Hurtati Limbongo and then dropping some bombs to end that round. Look at that. Countered the push kick to throw that big right hand. Look at her throwing it again. Landing with the overhand right, catches the sidekick. Unorthodox catch on that sidekick too. To throw the overhand right to piece it up. Priscilla Hertati Lumbong goal. Very impressive so far from Pooja Tomar, Michael Cervello.
That was the best round we have seen yet in Pooja Tomar's career. And look at the face of Priscilla Hertati Lumbong goal. The bumps, the scratches, the swelling. It tells a story. It's a story of late round dominance from Pooja Tomar. At the moment, you could hear tumbleweeds blowing through this enormous arena, because they are as shocked as we are at what Pooja Tomar did in the final 40 seconds of that opening round. Referee Olivia Koff to get us underway. What a show to kick off one championship in 2019. Southpaw stance on Priscilla. Hands up very high.
Tomar's got some heat behind that right hand. Look at her, she's countering off the kicks. When Tomar, when Priscilla Hertati Lumbong goal throws that right side kick, Tomar's countering it well.
Probing with the lead hand is the Indian, Pooja Tomar.
Yep, looking for that right hand.
Now the crowd rallies behind Priscilla. She got Tomar down.
The balance so far from Tomar. She's got that guillotine right there. Priscilla's got to keep her head up.
Moves to the top of the thigh from Priscilla Hertati Lumbong goal.
Tomar going for a killer throw again. You can see she was attempting that headlock to throw the side kick. Oh, a beautiful high kick on the right side there.
Priscilla coming forward. To the power of Tomar in the first round. And Tomar switching stance between southpaw and orthodox. Looks for the counter right hand off of Priscilla's kick.
That's what Tomar's trying to do. She's timing that kick. It doesn't matter where Priscilla Hertati Lumbong goal is throwing that kick from. Tomar's timing it brilliantly.
3 minutes 25 remains. Second round of three. First round of great finish by Pooja Tomar. The ground and pound was spectacular, and she also kicked the back, trying to choke out Priscilla Hertati Lumbong. One kick there from Tomar. Two Wushu champions in the cage. Tomar is trying to put herself on the map in this very heated atomweight division. A win here for Priscilla Hertati Lumbong would see her maybe only one match away for a possible world title tilt.
Adam, wait, division's really interesting right now, Michael, especially with the champ, Angela Lee, going up to challenge for the strawweight belt. Well, it's a very interesting situation right now for the atomweights.
Angela will take on Zhongjin Nan for the strawweight world title in Japan, Tokyo, March 31st. Sidekick there from Priscilla Hertati Lumbong. Tomar very patient. She won't overextend herself. She'll wait for an opening. Buys that roundhouse kick off the lead length and puts it in the back as she goes to orthodox stance. Tried to drop down for a single leg, but stuck in his choke attempt here. What's going on with the guillotine here, Mitch?
She's got an arming guillotine. You can see the arm there of Priscilla Hertati Lumbong goal. So it's a bit difficult to do it, especially from the standing position. But she chooses to let it go. Now Priscilla's got her pressed up against the cage. You gotta see Pooja Tomar get some underhooks. Right now she's got 50-50 position, one under, one over. Good job by Pooja Tomar to defend that.
Priscilla reaches forward again. She's in the pink and gray. Pooja Tomar, the white, wild uppercut. Almost took out the ring lights.
You can see that Pooja Tomar is countering off the one shot thrown by Priscilla Hertati Lumbong goal. Priscilla's throwing one punch, one kick, and then Tomar's coming back with a flurry. And that's how she's being successful.
We're seeing those Wushu sidekicks employed again by both these martial artists. Priscilla faking there. Fakes the jab out of southpaw stance. Now they clinch up.
Press so far with Priscilla's defense from the clinch. She's going for the 50-50 positions. She's making sure she has the body lock. She's going to show some good balance. Just as I say that, she gets dumped on the back.
triangle here from Puja Tomo on the bottom.
Listen to this crowd go crazy for Priscilla Hurtado Lombardo. The knee on belly for Priscilla. Look at Priscilla tie her up in a demented game of Twister. She's going to hunt after a submission. They're both playing a submission game, Dragon.
Not much there. Possible knee bar. Oh, wait. Is she going to go out of it? That was close.
Oh, Tomo looks like she's in pain.
Oh, Tomo thought about the tab.
Tomo's grimacing.
Oh, did it quite happen?
Pops her in the jaw. Just letting her know she's still there. Crazy scene to end the round. Just as Tomo ended the first round strongly, Hurtado Lombardo finishes the second round strongly.
Tomar's still on her back. A little bit of exhaustion. Let's see some of the action from the past. Look at this, Tomar coming in and just goes up top with a beautiful right roundhouse to the chin of Priscilla Hurtado Lombardo. Now that round was a little bit closer. Let's take a look at this attempt here at a knee bar. I think that's a little bit too far into the submission sequence, but you can see Priscilla Hurtado Lombardo was cranking the knee in an unorthodox position, and Tomar thought about the tap, but she managed to shrug it off and stay in it. Two rounds down so far, but very interesting atomweight showdown.
Full. And it's all coming down to this. The third and final round inside the sold-out Istora Senayan in Jakarta, Indonesia. It's one championship eternal glory. This atomweight showdown between Puja Tomo of India and Priscilla Hurtado Lombardo of Indonesia. Champion versus champion. Two Wushu champions are showing off their striking prowess.
Match right now, Michael Cervello. This is definitely the pinnacle of Puja Tomar's competitive career. She has put on a very good performance. Priscilla Hurtado Lombardo has got to shift gears on this and level up.
Puja Tomar has come out here tonight to show the watching world that she is not cannon fodder. Just missed with a counter. Here we go. Boom! Shakalaka! The crowd loves it in Jakarta.
Puja Tomar's got an arm in guillotine. Crank it on the neck. Priscilla Hurtado Lombardo is going to pick her back up.
Pops the head out, does Priscilla. They are raising the roof in Jakarta for Priscilla Hurtado Lombardo.
Oh, look at Priscilla dropping down to attack the leg. Looks like she's going for a Boston crab here, Michael.
Trying to employ her inner Rick Martel. Tough position for Priscilla Hurtado Lombardo. Close guard from Toma. Can she posture up here, Priscilla? And the chance go up again. Listen to this. Absolutely crazy scenes of pandemonium inside the Istora Senayan in Jakarta.
Puja Tomar still got the guard. She's got a ton of attacks. She's just trying to keep the head nice and close, or possibly hoping for a stand-up. But you can see that Priscilla's being just active enough to delay that possible stand-up. See how she's patting the head? A little bit of activity. Tomar's got to push away and stand back up.
Priscilla hasn't won by submission since February last year. The scarf hold arm lock. I should say against Ron Trinidad. That was in May of last year. She did it to Jake Drone. Before that was a scarf hold arm lock against Crystal Lombardo. Little bit of downward elbow there in the ground and pound. And Puja closes that guard. Tries to keep it tight. She doesn't want those hands, those elbows raining down on her face.
Tomar's not being very active in the guard. She's at least got to start creating a little bit of space so she can throw some elbows to do a little bit of damage on this. You can see, just because you're on top does not necessarily mean you're winning, especially in our scoring. So she's got to be a little bit more active from the bottom. She's got to create space. She's got to attack. She's got to try to advance her position. You can see Priscilla's just touching her up. She's not really doing anything. She's not really creating any damage on this.
What the finish? 1 minute 40 remaining. Third and final round. Priscilla trying to break open the crowd of the Indian. Scenes, glow sticks are waving, everybody's chanting, they're out of their seats inside the soldier, he's put a Senayan.
Pooja's got to be a little bit more active here, she's got to create some separation. Right now she's just holding on to the head. I think she believes she's too far ahead so far, so she's not trying to create any movement. I'd like to see her open a guard, get her butterfly hooks in because you can see how much forward pressure, how far she's leaning over, Mrs. Sweeper! Gives up her back in the process, Michael.
Oh, Priscilla has the back. Is this the beginning of the end?
Oh, this would be magnificent.
They're going to go nuts if she taps her. They're going to go crazy if she taps her.
Tomar's tough. She's hanging in there. That's close.
Referee Olivia Cross right on top of the action.
Tomar's got to pull the hands off her head. She's got to pull those hands off.
25 seconds on the clock. She's going to soften her up a little more now.
Punch her way home. 18 seconds. Tomar's going to
the left hand. And Tomar tried to defend against those punches. Final 10 seconds. Catch it, choker. That's more of a face crack.
Look at Tomar. She's got to spin. She can spin.
Strongly as she did in the second. This was one for the ages.
But does it come down to the damage that Tomar did in the first half, or does it come down to the positioning of Priscilla Hertati Lumbongol in the second half? Very close round. There's Priscilla Hertati picking her up and sending her back down. But then she was able to secure the back position, land a lot of ground and pound, and attempt to choke. I don't know if the judges are going to count that as a near finish, which counts as our highest scoring category, but that was a very entertaining match, Michael Ciavello.
Wherever you're watching in 138 countries, how did you score it? For Pooja Tomar or for Priscilla Hertati Lumbongol? The Indian or the Indonesian? Okay, let's go to Tom Lau, find out our winner.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. Judge number one calls this contest in favor of the red corner. Judge number two scores this contest in favor of the blue corner. And judge number three calls this contest in favor of your winner by split decision from the blue corner, Pooja Tomar.
Pooja Tomar pulls off a major upset. She spoils the Indonesian party. Someone forgot to show Pooja Tomar the script. Nobody expected that. She is emotional.
Hey guys, it's Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.